So, in this lecture, we're going to be talking about skills. You probably have some skills that people pinpointed at some point. You know that you personally have some skills that you know you're good at something, and there's a lot of people around you who say that you're really good at this, or the results show you that you're really good at this. If you win every single basketball game that you ever played, well, you know that you have some skills in basketball. If you're able to code an entire app in 2 days, well, then you know that you have skills. And skills are different than talent. Talent is something that people are born with. There are some people who are born with a certain tendency to do something more than anything else, right? You have some people who started coding when they were 8 years old, and you have people who started coding when they're 18, right? Now, the difference is, yes, sure, some people are born with a talent, but if they don't work on this talent, it won't help them. They need to improve it. But if you have somebody who worked on a skill and he worked on it harder than the person with a talent, well, this skill might grow to beat whoever had the talent, right? Why? Because skills grow with practice. Practice makes perfect. It helps you in growing your skills and improving your skills, but one skill at a time. As we talked before, we talked about taking it one step at a time, right? And it takes time to be skillful at something. So what you need to do is, for example, if you want to become really good at digital marketing, is to first, if you want to be skillful, you need to break it down into steps. What's the first step? The first step is to get familiar with digital marketing, doing some research about it. Maybe the second step would be to implement one of the strategies you learned. Third step would be to monitor the results. Fourth step would be to use trial and error to see if this is something that you need to keep working on or improve, right? And at the end, after you do all of these things, trial and error, and you keep repeating and you try and you do, go through all the different steps, you get to a point where you can say, well, digital marketing is one of my skills. But if out of the blue, with no testing whatsoever, no learning and nothing, you just throw a digital marketing campaign out there, well, it's not gonna work. It's not. And it doesn't matter how hard you work on launching a marketing campaign, if you don't take the first steps, that can take you to the step number 15 in order for you to be able to be skillful at something, well, it's not gonna work. The most important factor of productivity is how skilled you are at what you do. So always find ways to improve your skills, and in return, your skills will improve your productivity and get things done faster and better. If you play guitar and you want to learn, let's say, a basic 1 minute solo, it would take you, let's say, when you're first starting, it would take you 10 hours to perfect it, right? And when you first started, if you wanted to play an advanced solo, a 4 minute advanced solo, it would maybe take you a year and you wouldn't even be able to play it. But when you become skillful at the guitar and you work hard on it and you become on an advanced level, then when we give you the 1 minute beginner solo, you'd maybe master it in, I don't know, 2 minutes. But when we give you the advanced 4 minute solo, it won't take you a year, it maybe take you 10 days. So when you become skillful, things get done faster and they get done better. So eventually, being skillful at something will help you with your time management because you'll spend less time doing the things that matter the most. You will be able to finish the critical 20% of the tasks faster and better, giving you time for other goals that you want to work on, or if you don't have any other work that you want to work on, it will give you time for you to be able to finish the 80% that is left and have a lot of time for you to just sit down and chill and do whatever you want to do, watch Netflix or go out with friends, right? So the one reason why every successful person reads on a daily basis, they always say read, the more you read, the better is not to enjoy reading, but to continually learn and apply that knowledge to their skills, because they know that everything they're learning might and most probably will help them be more skillful at whatever they're doing or whatever they're seeking to get better at. And Warren Buffett says, the more you learn, the more you earn, and it's for a reason, because, well, the more you learn, the more skillful you become, the easier it will be for you to tackle big tasks and big goals. And when you do tackle bigger goals and bigger tasks, you will earn more because they are worth more. When you're on skill level number one, there are probably thousands of millions of people on the same level. But when your skill level is on level 30 and to perfect it, it's level 40, well, you'll be one of the top people in whatever you're doing, right? And that's why you will definitely earn more. But the only way to get there is to work on your skills. As I said, even talented people, if they don't keep working on their skills, they will lose it, right? A lawyer could never win a case without him knowing the law and applying it over and over and over again. The more you learn, the more you are able to get things done in the right way. So, what does it have to do with time management? Well, I'm pretty sure a lot of you figured it out. Any skill can be learned, and if practiced and improved on a regular basis, this skill helps you get things done faster and would save a lot of time. So, how do you master the skills? You spend at least 30 minutes a day reading a book that is related to your skills, and then you try to apply. A lot of people read, but they don't apply what they read. You need to read something related to your skills and start implementing it right away. Second thing is that you need to spend time at, for example, conventions, seminars. Go to events that would help you get more skills. If there is a big marketing convention happening around you, go there. There's going to be a lot of people, a lot of the top people in the field, and they'll be able to help you a lot more than books. And once they do, also, you need to implement whatever you learn from them. You need to implement that into your skills to be able to harness the skill better and be able to master it faster and better. And of course, as we're talking about time management, wanna limit the stuff that consume our time with absolutely no help towards our goals. So for example, listen to audiobooks instead of music whenever you are commuting, because when you listen to audiobooks, you'll be getting information about your skill and you'll be able to implement everything you heard on the audiobook, and you'll grow your skills faster. Last step is to repeat. Practice makes perfect. I said it before and I'm saying it again, because the only way to go is to keep on repeating. If you don't repeat, you'll get to stair number 5 and then you stop. You won't be able to master the skill there. You need to repeat, read more books, get more knowledge, go to more conventions, know more about this skill, practice it more in order for you to get closer to being an expert, a fully blown, skillful expert in whatever industry you're trying to get into. Knowledge is the key to any skill, and mastering a skill will make you a tremendous change in whatever it is that you're doing. You'll feel more confident and more successful. You'll be able to finish bigger tasks in less time, and you'll be able to finish it even more efficiently, and the end result would be better.